action slips. We love action slips.
Yes!
All right, you know how it goes. I need actions. I need lots of actions. And since there are only like six of you, right? Well, that's it. I need lots of volume. Bring it. What?
Flossing.
I got it.
We're over here.
Going through a haunted house.
What?
Going through a haunted house.
Going through a haunted house.
Carving a pumpkin.
Hey, I've seen a theme here.
Flossing and carving a pumpkin.
Carving a pumpkin?
I got carving a pumpkin.
Bullfighting. Bullfighting from the back.
Piercing someone's ear.
More. Putting on a disguise.
Doing the Macarena and a tutu.
Falling down from exhaustion at the end of a marathon. Alright? Write your novel. Come back to me. Come on.
Coming up at a party.
Throwing up at a party. These can be simple too as running. Running is one. That's too easy.
That is too easy, thank you.
Okay, I have completed.
All right, she's completed the Great American Novel.
Getting a haircut. Eating a cactus.
Petting. That's much better. Filming a dating video.
Knitting a pair of leg warmers.
Yeah.
Hula hooping. We got hula hoop. You need say three or four more.
Putting on rocket shoes.
We got putting on rocket shoes. Yeah. Two more.
Flash dance.
Pull-ups. What?
Flash dance.
Flash dancing and one more. Blowing up the Death Star. It's the big finale. All right. You got those? Let's bring it back in.
Crazy.
Right. Now, let's see, where are we going to put these fellas? What are we going to do with these guys? I have no idea either. It's really... What might you be doing that you don't want to get sweaty doing?
Television.
Doing television. You're on it.
I love this trip.
You two are producing a new television show. That's going to be the suggestion for the action slips. For the new television shows, action slips. In 3, 2, 1, go.
I'm sorry. I don't think I can go on and do this. This show is stupid. Zombies? Hello? I wrote this show based on my life. You live with zombies?
I did. Who are you to question me? I hired you because of your beard. I can find many other people with beards, if I have to.
Maybe not some as deliciously white, checkered, salt and pepper as mine.
Let's stop this. I want you to go back to scene one.
Fine, hold on.
No!
It's too late. My hair is gone.
You actor types are ridiculous. You take the one good thing that I like about you and you completely destroy it.
I know, I'm method acting.
Well, I'm gonna have to get something to replace that. Here, from the chest of the 80s props, a couple of these, instead of wearing them on your legs, just hang them from your face and it looks the same. And it'll keep your chin warm.
I feel like a maniac.
Oh, there's a weird thread. Are you ready? We have to start filming, okay?
Don't want broccoli in my teeth on camera. Hello, Mr. Director, Producer,
granted,
Man.
Granted. Alright, Star Wars Episode 8 is not going to make itself, you know. Let's go to the scene where we, you know, destroy that thing, alright? And run. wonderful your script is, but thank you. Yes, I spent time over last dinner. Nancy. You actor types. I tell you what. I can't handle this. I need to reduce my stress. Here, Bendy. Come here. Yes, here. All right. Yes, you and your long pink neck. You just calm me and soothe me. Yes, stand on one leg.
Finally, a co-star.
No, he's mine. I can't do Star Wars Episode 8 by myself, Mr. Director Man. You mean to use Bendy?
Bendy?
In your scene.
I can bend Bendy. Anytime. I need to. Bring Bendy here.
I don't know if he's got these.
Stud, I think it's in his eye, though.
Now he's a pirate, Bendy. Space pirates, episode 8. Look. We're missing something.
Do we need a rewrite?
I can rewrite. Yes. From the Nutcracker. Put these on.
Who?
Yes. Put these on. All right. We need a dance number. I'll show you. It needs to be something like this. Like this. Yes. Lots of action. Lots of... Yes. All right. So keep... Don't do that in the scene, but with that energy, that mentality, the charisma, I want you to now... Eat this cactus. I keep it here on my desk.
Okay.
I want you to feel the pain, and that pain that you feel in your throat, I want you to internalize.
That's actual physical pain.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
I can feel the blood going through.
That's all. Yes, good. All right, now take that.
Okay. All right, I feel it.
Okay, talk to Princess Leia's granddaughter.
I will. Leia! Leia, where are you?
Shoot! Cut it, do it! Cut! Fine, okay.
I just went cactus juice.
Well, the producer threw a past party for us at the end of the workday today. Let's just go. I didn't even have a cactus.
That's really gnarly.
Alright. But we might as well relax and enjoy ourselves. We can't get a whole lot of productivity done today because that's all party it up.
Well, I'm going to take this off.
This is stupid.
Instead, I'm going to wear my normal gear that I like to wear when I feel sexy. Weird hat.
Oh no, I forgot something back in my car. Unfortunately, the closest parking space I could find in the studio was 26.2 miles away. I'll be back.
Hooray!
And So, what that means is if you want to make the move forward, you tap them behind,
Not all the way around. They'll do the walking, they're talking for you. They won't do the walking, they'll do that for you. They'll do the talking for you. I think we've got through all the range of motions. Don't make them fall off the stage. Don't make them punch each other. Don't make them make out. Don't make them fall down to the ground.
Excuse me, what if Ty's safety pin comes loose?
Put it back in.
Okay.
Don't ask where it is. All right. Just curious. He's got a zipper problem. It came loose while I was walking up the stairs. He's like, ow, ow, ow. So I put it back together. Don't worry. So, please. We need a suggestion for this scene. Something that your mother. Something that your mother would never want you to have as a job. That's not dirty, she just doesn't think you should do that. A what? That's dirty. Oh, floor strip. Something that your mom doesn't want you to have as a job, she thinks it's too menial. Rockstar, you can give the suggestions, you're up here. A what? A teacher? Yeah, I know, that's menial as well. Alright, so this has something to do with being a teacher, or teaching, or Tashaw. Just French for teaching. Puppet Master, in 3, 2, and 1.
I'm quitting this job. I can't deal with these kids anymore.
Oh, you know what? You're so right. I want to quit too.
Let's walk out. Let's do it together.
We will. This way.
You'll back me up?
I'm in front, but yes.
What a bitch!
Not anymore! Oh my god! You're so quick!
That's right!
Whoa! Hey!
Look! If we band together, we can tear this school apart!
Oh! I left a pickaxe on the other side of the stage! That way!
A pickaxe could have some use, sorry!
He's falling everywhere! Why are you so fast? Quitting. You always beat me to everything.
What? You're jealous of me? You're jealous of my speed?
It's okay, I picked up the pickaxe for us.
Oh, no!
I distracted you. Ha!
Alright, fine. Look, we can do this. We can do this together.
I'm ready. Alright, let's go take down the bricks first.
Alright. They're that way!
Okay! This is probably why we never get picked for anything in the school. We don't know where anything is.
I don't even know where my classroom is. I haven't been in 10 years. Those kids don't know what they're missing.
I'm gonna slowly follow you.
I don't know where I'm going!
Wait for you to tell me where. Oh, I'm just gonna do it. I'm just gonna pick out right here.
Just do that one.
But I'm gonna look really manly while I do it.
Always did.
Thank you. I get really upset sometimes because I teach drama. I'm just going to keep pickaxing. Okay, I'm stuck. No, I'm going to keep going. I teach drama and people make fun of me all the time for it.
I made fun of you a lot. I have to admit. But I've learned now. I've learned that this wall is what's been between us.
Right now, nothing's between us.
MC!
Some of you to pick out a script for this next scene, and I need someone who's going to be able to read a script. Can someone help me? Anyone who knows how to read and can speak better than I can? Anybody? All you have to do is read. Anybody knows how to read? No, you don't know how to read. Anybody who does know how to read?
Just grab somebody. Someone in that table right there.
Jasmine, you're next in line. It's your. All right, Jasmine. Okay, you don't have to come up with anything to say because you get to read from the script that Kelsey has for you. She's going to give you the instructions here for this scene. Meanwhile, I'm going to talk to the rest of the folks here. So, in this scene, Chris is going to be experiencing what we call an actor's nightmare. It's a real life phenomenon where you have a dream that you're on stage, you have to perform this play or something, but you don't know what you're supposed to say, and it's very scary. And so we're going to recreate that here on stage. Chris has no idea what this play or this scene is about or what to say. Jasmine does, however. She's on a script of a real play. And she's going to be reading the lines of a character over there. And Chris will have to be interacting with her, and as if he knows exactly what's going on when he doesn't. So what we need from the rest of you is anything, like, what... It kind of gave you a bad day. It's not disastrous, but what happened to you right before this scene here? What happened to Chris right before this scene happened? Something happened, he has news to share. It's not great news. It's not disastrous.
A parking ticket,
okay? So you got a parking ticket prior to this scene, okay? And we're gonna see what happens next with the help of Jasmine on microphone.
Your Honor, this parking ticket is bogus.
Enjoying yourself?
No, I just got a $472 ticket for parking at a meter too long.
Yes.
That's the ticket you're for. You guys have a sign up here that says, complaint, see the judge. I'm here, Your Honor, with pleading. I don't have $475.
Thinking.
Think faster! I gotta go to work, and if I lose my job, I definitely won't have $475.
Why don't you read a book?
I can't read! The only reason I know the tickets at $475 was the last police officer who was laughing at me told me.
So, I'm thinking.
I do that a lot, don't you? God, I'd hate to be here for a murder trial. Or maybe it'd be good, he'd never sentence me. What's the verdict, please, Judge?
Sorry. Shush. Enjoy your music.
Thought I had these hidden. They're the small iPod ears that you can put in and no one notices. I apologize.
Why not?
Well, I thought it would be rude to wear visible earmuff headphones here.
We can enjoy different things.
True. I'd enjoy not getting a ticket, you'd probably enjoy giving it to me.
But I can enjoy your music.
Are you asking for a bribe, Judge? You want me to give you my iPod to get out of the ticket?
Vibrations.
But it's an old iPod, I can shake it real fast for you while you listen to it.
Really?
Yes, I'm good at shaking! I can shake the hell out of this thing, Judge.
The vibrations don't have a sound, but they do have a feel. Fast, slow, very intense, not so intense.
I think you're offering me something different from a bribe, Judge.
And when I see people dancing, I feel still more.
So let me get this straight. You want me to vibrate you fast and slow and dance to get out of my tickets while listening to my iPod music? All right, Judge. It's Nirvana.
No, I can feel it.
Oh! I'm sorry. I didn't know you didn't like your body. You felt me down in your heart goggles.
Don't be sorry.
I'm not sorry then. Feel it the way you want to feel it, Judge, but please get me out of this ticket.
Shush! No! Don't be, please.
I...
Yes?
Your Honor, if I may approach the bench, which I've been doing, I have a ticket that needs erasing. That music and...